information, news, and entertainment on demand.
WSRadio.com.
Accomplishment Coaching is proud to present the following fine programming. Accomplishment Coaching, where coaches lead and leaders coach. AccomplishmentCoaching.com.
Welcome to Leadership Insights Radio.
Thank you for listening into this special episode in our series, 2020 Business Vision. We're inviting thought leaders from many industries to share their forecasts for this upcoming year. In this episode, we're joined by Michael Houlihan, who founded, grew, and exited Barefoot Wines, and I encourage you to learn all about that amazing story in Michael's book, The Barefoot Spirit. Go to thebarefootspirit.com, and you can learn all about it, get the book, and learn so much more. However, on today's show, our focus isn't on wine, but it's on Michael's ongoing journey as an entrepreneur. Welcome to the show, Michael.
Thanks for having me, Wade. Looking forward to it.
Oh, yeah. I look forward to hearing all of your insights. And because of your great insights and this interesting new project that you're doing involving narrative podcasting, I'm going to combine what are typically two different questions. You know, what are you doing and what are you forecasting for the future? And what I'd like to do is pull those together into one big question and just turn you loose on it. So tell us about this narrative podcasting project that you're developing and what you're seeing in this whole world of media, online, marketing, digital, however you want to define that stew, and what you're seeing there that's driving you in this direction for this project.
Yeah, that's a great question, Wade. Bonnie and I have been speaking for about 4 years. We've spoken at over 60 schools that teach entrepreneurship. And really, the changes have happened during that same period of time. You know, 4 years ago, almost nobody would enter an auditorium wearing earbuds. But now it seems like everybody's wearing earbuds. And so about a year and a half ago, I decided to ask a stupid question. And I said, hey, what do you listen to? Is it hip-hop? Is it rap? You know, I thought it was some kind of, you know, music. And a lady said, no, I'm listening to War and Peace. And a young gentleman said, no, I'm listening to a podcast on how to improve my business.
Right.
And I thought to myself, well, isn't this interesting? These people are walking around mobile, you know, they're untethered, unlike video, unlike print. They are not immobilized, so they're totally mobilized. You know, much the way we were back in the old days when we put a cassette or a disc in our dashboard and listen to a lecture on our way from San Francisco to San Diego. But they're doing it on a regular basis, and we thought, isn't this interesting? You know, I wonder, you know, if we shouldn't start to examine this.
Yeah, if I can just build on that, you know, we've been doing this for 18 years. We started before anybody knew what a podcast was. And as we've been watching it evolve, we realized of the three screens we have, big one on the walls for entertainment, a small one on our desktop for productivity, but we've got this little one that contains our life that we carry around with us everywhere. And we realized that that's going to be the platform for podcasting because since podcasting doesn't have the visual element, it allows for multitasking. It's going to go on the treadmill. It's going to go on the walk with you. It's going to go sit next to you while you're doing dishes. You're seeing that play out, and it really is part of that bigger picture of the world of mobile, which has the mantra of anything, anywhere, anytime. And this is just how the world of audio and media is learning to live in that world of mobile. Does that reflect on what you're seeing?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So we said, well, maybe we should create an audio book. And so we decided to listen to some audio books. Uh-huh. So, you know, we had never listened to an audio book before, but we listened to like four or five audio books. And What we noticed about them all was that they were either read to us by the author or they had hired a narrator to narrate them for you. Uh-huh. And even though the narrator might have been a Hollywood actor, it was still, you know, kind of single dimensional. It was one person reading it to you. And then one day we're driving across the Arizona desert, and here comes Prairie Home Companion, and it's Guy Noir. It's an audio skit
right.
of this private detective. It's kind of a comedy. But, you know, we noticed that this is like three or four actors and actresses and sound effects people that are actually doing a production. They're not narrating it. They're performing it.
She needed to make it solid. She needed Michael to draw it. And she needed this to happen fast. That's why she was almost vibrating to get it out and why she hustled a half-asleep Michael to the little green chalkboard in the kitchen.
I know what the label looks like. This is going to be a big success. I could see it stacked in supermarkets. This is going to sell a lot of wine.
Michael picked up the chalk and started to draw.
Quick, quick, draw a foot.
What kind of foot?
A nice foot. Just draw it.
Right. And that's when we got the idea for business audio theater. And we noticed that several fiction books had been done that way, but nobody had really tackled a business book this way, which is how do you get a business principle concept across through a play-acted theatrical drama?
Yes, yes. And convey the emotion that engages people. You know, I've listened to audiobooks, some of them, you know, I'm not going to say that, I'm not going to bash them or whatever, but it does tend to be more exposition, more oratory. And as I'm listening to it, my mind might drift. Now, that might be good that I'm pondering what they said, but my mind might drift where I've noticed when I have, like you're saying, a performance, as the different characters interact, it just constantly is keeping my mind involved. Does that ring true?
Exactly. You know, we wanted to get people to engage. And, you know, reading a book is a big advance over, written books or even video, because now you are mobile. And
right.
we love that. So what is the next step after a narration? And we think it's performance. So we not only broke our book down into scenes with actions and outcomes and characters that have dialogue, you know, backed up by sound effects and music.
Right. That sounds incredible.
Yeah, it's kind of fun, you know. It's more like, but you know, we ran into an interesting problem, and that is that since it's never been done before, most of the sites, such as Amazon or Audible, their audiobook wing, doesn't really, they say fully narrated or fully casted performances, but they don't have a category for fully casted performances. So isn't that interesting? So we applied for the audio awards because we thought, well, this is kind of unique. Maybe we'll win an audio award for it. We didn't set out to be unique. We set out to be engaging. And it's interesting that now we're doing missionary work because we're having to tell people what it is, how it sounds, why it's different, and why it needs to have its own genre or category, really.
Right, right. I love how you were just wanting to be engaging and you discovered you're a bit visionary. And but also visionary in kind of a retro way, right? The world
it's
of
radio.
It's
very retro. As a matter of, yeah, it always reminds me of the family sitting around in their living room
right.
in 1945, and they're glued, their eyes are glued to the speaker of their big, you know, radio that's a big Philips radio or something
right.
with a big dial on it. And they're looking at it as if it was a screen. You know, they're transfixed on the speaker. And it's because the show is going on in their mind.
Right, right. And we've only got about 2 minutes left, so I appreciate your point. I want to reinforce that by also jumping on my own soapbox. I've done video. I've written for magazines. I run a podcasting network now. I'm media agnostic, right? There's times that we need video. There's times that we need print. There's times that we need audio. But I truly think that audio's theater of the mind superpower is woefully underappreciated. And I love that you aren't just going, okay, mobile is the new platform. Mobile's something I need to play in. You're going, and how do I make that better?
Exactly, exactly. And, you know, this is what we've tried to do all our lives, Bonnie and I, is, you know, what's the next challenge? How do we build on the last challenge? How do we make it better? You know, people want to buy the next big thing.
Exactly. So let me kind of tie a bow on this, and then I've got a couple of more really quick questions. So what you're seeing in the future is just recognizing our world is going mobile, and you are embracing that rather than fighting against that. And again, more than embracing it, going, how can I take this to a new level? And through these narrative podcasts, you're making literature come to life. So in just a few seconds, what website should we go to learn more about this amazing project?
Well, you can go to www.barefootaudiobook.com. And you can download a free chapter and see what it sounds like.
Okay, and final question, is there something in 2020 that you wish people either start or stop doing?
Okay, well, I hope that they stop trying to scale fast to fail fast. I hope that they learn the lessons from the barefoot spirit, which is to scale slow and don't let go. Ask lots of questions. Learn what it is that you're doing. Find out what your customer wants from you. Get your act together before you take your show on the road.
That is tremendous advice, and you can learn all about that and everything that Michael Houlihan's doing at thebarefootspirit.com. We'll be back again with another great episode of 2020 Business Vision here on WSRadio.com. We are the worldwide leader in internet talk.
If you heard that sound, you probably are eligible for insurance from Navy Mutual, insuring the men and women of the Navy, Marines, and Coast Guard. Here's what one policyholder, retired Navy Commander Thomas Dade, had to say.
Navy Mutual is the best insurance decision I ever made. I wish you had a savings plan available that earned the rates my Navy Mutual insurance has been earning.
Navy Mutual Aid Association, started by military members in 1879, serves active, reserve, and retired military today. Navy Mutual honors our military by providing them affordable life insurance with the features they need without fine print.